Hello, hello, it's me, Marky, and welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, I am going to talk about my monthly favorites in the month of July. So I described that this month has been very nostalgic based on the different things that I've encountered, and some of them just gives me like a glimpse of a memory from the past, which is really touching, but not to exaggerate, but yeah, that's what I feel about like some of them, I would say. Yeah. And I don't really have a lot to say about this month, so let's start, I guess. So the first section is clothing, and it's actually the thing that I'm wearing right now, which is a white button-up shirt with vertical stripes. And honestly, I love this shirt because it's like a bowling shirt. It's like an old shirt that an old person would wear. But I got this shirt from the thrift store for only $6, which is really cheap. And when I bought the shirt, my mom was like, "That's very out of touch." And I was like, "Exactly." Okay, proceed. And the next section is books. I love reading. I'm really into books. And the only problem was that I was in a reading slump, and I bought a lot of books just to defeat that reading slump. And these are the books that I got, and I actually purchased them like 3 different places. And my first go-to place when I buy books is of course Amazon. They're really cheap, and you can save a lot of money if you buy your books on Amazon. And the first book that I got is They Both Die at the End by Adam Silvera, and this is actually the first book that I read when I was in a reading slump. I loved it, and if you've read this book, let me know so that we can share our opinions on this lovely book right here. And the next book that I got is Turtles All the Way Down by the one and only John Green. I've been meaning to read this book. This one came out like last year or 2 years ago, and now I finally have it, and it's in a hardcover, and regularly if you buy them at Barnes & Noble, they'd be like $20. But for this one, I only got it for $11. What this is, and the last book that I got from Amazon is that just Summer Days and Summer Nights by a lot of like different authors. And the reason why I pick up this book is because it's summertime, you know, and you just want to read like a short story about the current season. I don't know. Yes. And the next place where I actually got my books from is a discount warehouse or something like that, and I got 2 books from that place. First of all is Paper Towns, another book by John Green, and I'm pretty sure you've heard about this book because they made a movie out of this, and I read this after They Both Die at the End, and this book is so good, and I have no idea why I haven't picked this out like 2 years ago. Never underestimate John Green. And the last book I got from the discount warehouse is Crazy Rich Asians by Kevin Kwan. And of course, I'm guessing you've all heard about this book because Crazy Rich Asians, that was like a blockbuster movie. And there's no need for me to explain it. And I haven't read this one yet. Last place that I got my books from is actually from an unexpected place, which is the dollar store. And I got 2 books from the dollar store, and guess what? They're only $1. And moving on to music, I'd say that I don't have any particular genre that I was listening to this month. It's just the vibe, I would say. Because I was picturing this in my head where you're having a road trip with your friends on an old Volkswagen on your way to Malibu or like any beach in particular. And the first song is like my go-to summer song, and I love playing this song every summer, and it's Million Bucks by Smallpools, and it's this song. And the next song is Sunproof by Courtship, and it's here's another song, which is Don't Take My Money by Bleachers. And actually, I love this band. It's the song. Here, And the last song is Talk Too Much by Kwan. I have a playlist on Spotify if you want to check it out, you know, so that we can listen to these bopping songs. Yeah. And we're halfway through our category, which is movies and TV. And actually, I've only seen one movie this month, and it's not even like a new movie. It's Baywatch, which came out like last year or maybe 2 years ago. And I underestimated this movie because I thought this would be like a summer typical like lifeguards movie, but it wasn't. It has a lot of action to it. I really love it. Half of the shows that I was binge watching were more of like throwback shows or like childhood shows, which is Gravity Falls, The Thundermans, and The Amazing World of Gumball. And I just love watching those shows because when I was young, those were the shows that I'd wake up to early morning. And yeah. And the other show, which I really, really love, was Pretty Little Liars. And the reason why I was rewatching this one because Netflix got rid of it, and which is so sad because I really love that show. I used to watch that show on my early years of high school, and yeah, you get to relive the moment and find out who A is. And the thing is, they have a spin-off series which is the Perfectionist, which is also good, by the way. I recommend you check that out if you love crime, like Pretty Little Liars as well. So check that out. And so here we have like new shows. I mean, they're not new, but like a new season came out, which is Stranger Things season 3. I'd say season 3 is the best season yet because season 1 is more about like the introduction to the upside down world and like Will's possession, and season 2 is more of like Elle facing her problems. Season 3 is amazing. I love season 3, and especially that music production. It's like Never Ending Story. That was a bop. And the next show is Queer Eye season 4. And I haven't finished season 4 yet because I don't want to waste all my tears at once. I want to get emotional like in different days. Is that weird? Yeah. And the next show that I want to talk about is a Hulu original. And this show is really good. People have been ignoring this show, but screw them. And that show is Light as a Feather, and it's so good. I thought this was like one of those shows that would be magic. Like, it's very mysterious and like it's very dark as well. And season 2 is even better than season 1. So I'd recommend you watch that. And the last section of this video is skincare. And I actually learned a lot of things from watching Queer Eye. And I learned from JVN that skincare isn't vanity, it's taking care of yourself. So I did my research on like different skincare products and how they would treat my face. I have 3 skincare products right now. And the first one is, of course, Cetaphil. And this is like the most common moisturizing lotion. It's for your face and for your body as well. It's expensive, but it's worth it. And the next product is actually a small product, which is tea tree oil. Tea tree oil is good for your face, your scars, your scalp. And the last product is actually a facial spray. And it's called Mario Badescu. It's a facial spray. It has aloe, cucumber, and green tea, and it keeps your face moisturized naturally. So you just spray this on your face. Yeah! So those are the stuff that I was obsessing to on the month of July. So that is all I have for this video, and give this video a big thumbs up. And yo, you should subscribe to my channel because I post creative content and their aesthetic as well. So yeah, I'll see you soon on my next video. Bye.